Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. On today's video, we're going to do something different. Something different for this channel especially. Now, usually here you may get a couple of motivational tips on how to improve your life in certain areas, how to handle certain issues and problems. You may see more about my books, the meaning of my story, etc. You might even see a little bit about music and health and arts and all of the above. But today we're going to do a closet introduction video. Now, with this video, I'm going to give you tools to organizing your closet, how to make your closet more suitable for you, and so that it's so easy for you to function on a daily basis and be able to keep it organized and pretty. So I'm going to introduce you to my closet like it's a person or something, and I'm going to show you the different pieces, the way that I organize it, how I keep it organized, etc. Okay, let's go. So behind me is my closet. You see this? Behind me is my closet. Okay, now let me show you guys how I organize my closet. So I've organized my closet multiple times. I have an issue, like at first I might have organized it by color, and so I had everything color coordinated. Secondly, I went back in and then I thought I had organized it by hanger color as well. So the hangers were in certain areas for certain things. Then I went back in because again, things switched up, things changed. And I was like, you know what? Not only am I gonna color coordinate it, not only am I hanger organizing it, I also am hanging it by the pieces worn in certain seasons, okay? So I'm gonna show you all what I did and give you tips as we go along. So, tool number one. If you want a great looking, beautiful, see if I back up, you can see like great organization and color scheme to a closet. The number one tip that I would give you is to organize your closet by color. Now, you may be a person who wears some of the same color pieces. Say you wear a lot of black, say you wear a lot of white, say you wear a lot of nudes. Then your closet would definitely look extraordinary if you have it separated by the blacks, the whites, the nudes. And me being the overly organized person that I am, I would go into each section and organize the blacks by my pieces I could wear more so in the summer to the fall to the winter. I would go to the whites and organize my pieces by what I can wear in the summer, maybe the fall, and maybe early winter. And then I would go to my nudes and do the same. And so I would have each piece in each section color coordinated so that it looks aesthetically beautiful, but I would also organize the pieces within each section. So let me show you what I did. Okay, so here, I don't know if you guys can see all the way back here. Okay, here I organized it with whites first. Why? Because it's the lightest pieces that I have, and it's also pieces that of course would go usually in the summertime, all of the colorful, more brighter pieces. So I started off with white. Here you may see a few mixed prints. Why? Because they are still white or black, but they have a little bit of print or color in them. I wear a lot of color, so you'll see some pieces with color. Now all of these pieces here, you see the cheetah print. If you look in between, it has nudes, it has snake print, cheetah print. All of that is in one section. All of that is in one area in between separating a color section, okay? So here you'll see a couple of pieces, but they all have this pink or mauve color in them, and that's why they're all in that section together, okay? Now, with this section here, I went from my lighter pastel colors to my prints, my mixed prints, and then I went to my hot pink, my hot orange, and my melanie colors. So here is the hot pinks, the orange, the reds, the melanie colors. There's pieces in between them all that you have to actually get in between to see. Here we went to the darker colors that come right after those, which are all reds, burgundies, etc. And if you look within, they are all the same color tones. And so if you see it afar, it for the most part may look a little colorful, but that's because it's summer pieces that have such a variety of design in them, but they are color coordinated. And so with these pieces as well, I made sure to put all summer pieces in the beginning of my closet. Right now it's summer, so this is the side that I'll be grabbing the most from. These are the pieces that I'll be most likely wearing. So I organize all my pieces that are summer. If you can see from where you are, all of these pieces, except for this one, has sleeves, these two, but all of these pieces have short sleeves, no sleeves, literally sleeveless. They are very cool and breezy and very what I would say suitable for the weather that we're currently in. Now here, this dress, I wouldn't say this is necessarily suitable for summer that we're in. This beautiful dress I wore on my birthday when I turned, I believe, 22 years old in Vegas. And so it was hot, but I wore it inside the hotel to a restaurant only. But you know, these pieces are literally organized by color. If you see how I'm sliding up, each piece is literally the same color scheme as you go into it. You know, they are very colorful pieces, but they're all within the same color scheme. Now, if you've noticed in this section as well, all of these pieces have white hangers. So I not only organized it by color scheme, I also went in and colored my hangers. I made sure that the summer section has all white hangers for the most part. And these are just the pieces that are hung. I also have stuff in drawers organized as well, and I may do that in another video if you all want me to. So with the summer pieces, I organize them by color. I organize them by season as well. This is all of my summer colorful pieces organized by color with white hangers, because that reminds me of summer. So if you go here towards the middle section of my closet, you will see these two blue, 3-4 blue green hangers are all of my pants. They are my pants that are not jeans. So these are all of my pants that are not jeans, that for the most part I only wear dark burgundy pants or black pants. You know, if you see on the hangers, there's only black and burgundy pants that are on these blue and green hangers. Now to my pink hangers. If you can see from afar with my pink hangers, they are all jeans. So these are my jean hangers. If you go in between, you will see these are literally all individual jeans on a pink hanger. So when I go to my closet and I'm looking for a pair of jeans, and they're also color coordinated. I don't know if you can tell from where the camera is, but if you can see, these are my lighter color jeans all the way to my darker color jeans. And so in between, you'll see the medium blues and they go darker as you go. So if I know if it's summertime and I'm trying to wear a pair of jeans, I'll quickly grab a light color pair of jeans off the hanger. And they're so individually wrapped that I can see which pair it is by the rips, by the style, by the design. Pick it up, put it back in there. Even when I wear a pair of jeans or I wear a top from my closet, I may take it out, I may wear it for the day. I put the hanger in the exact spot of where the piece was, so that once I do wash these pieces and put them back in my closet, I know exactly where I got this piece from. I know exactly where in the closet I could go back and grab what specific piece and be like, okay, perfect, and put it right back on its hanger in its belonging space. And you usually look around and the colors are the same. Like I said, it's color coordinated. So it's not only number one, color coordinated. It's not only number two, season coordinated. These are the summer clothes. In the middle, you'll get all of my pants and my jeans. Then you'll get my fall winter clothes back there. It's number one, color coordinated. Number two, season coordinated. Number three, hanger coordinated. So I literally can look up at the hangers and grab a piece. And so let me give you a quick example of why this is helpful for me. I had to go to an event. I was going to an event. It was starting at a certain time. It was not in my area. It was close to 2 hours away, okay? And so I had to get to this event quickly. I had been busy all day. I only had a short time frame and it began raining. And so I needed someone that was in my home to grab something for me. The great part about having my closet so organized is I didn't have to come in and fuss about where this piece is or show them or literally try to get them to dig in a junk pile and try to find it. I literally was able to tell them, okay, go to this hanger. It'll be in this section with the white hangers. It'll be in the red section and it looks like this, and they are able to grab it and pick it up. And so it can help me out, so I could just keep it moving and don't have to get out the car, get ready, do, you know, a whole nine when there are moves to be made. Okay, so that's just a number one way that this is so helpful for you. So if you see here, this is the fall winter section. Don't look at the shoes yet. They're semi-organized, but they're going to get better. So here, These are a pair of pants, cream color, that I wore to my cousin that passed away funeral. Those are the only color cream pants that I have, so that's why they're kind of there in the front. And plus, I would only wear them probably in fall, not necessarily winter. These are all of my skirts that I would wear in winter, because this one, if you can see the material of it, it's a very thick skater shaped skirt. These are black pencil skirts or black and white pencil skirts, and they're all in the same section and or hangers. Now here you will see my grays. You will see all of the different grays. They are assorted with black and whites in the middle because they sometimes have gray in them. And then you'll see my nudes. If you go even deeper, you will literally see these are all cream colored nude color clothing. Then I have my mauve pink winter clothing. Then it goes to the green. So you see the dark greens are here. You see the blues, and then you go to the burgundies. And in the very back, there is nothing but black clothes. There is nothing but black clothes. Now, as a person who wears a lot of color, I also have a lot of black pieces. Black pieces have become so essential as I've become an adult. I've learned that you need some solid pieces. So I've had to add to my closet solid pieces, whether solid black, solid nude, or solid white. You need solid pieces so that when you do wear color, it will settle the look down and you won't look like a clown, like you're just throwing on a bunch of clothes with different colors, not being specific about what you're doing. But if you look in this section, which I said is all winter and fall clothes, they all have black hangers. So I made sure that I separated them with black hangers. My jeans again has pink hangers. My pants that are colored black or burgundy has blue green hangers, and my summer clothes has all white hangers in that section. Up top, I have my hats. If you can see them in the back, they are lightly stacked. This is a couple of books that I'm either currently working on, currently writing, and or currently just going back to check on every now and again. So you'll see those little books right there just stacked. I write in my journal every day. That has to be in here. Here are a couple of new purses I just got. Like, isn't this the cutest? I'm going to show you all when I actually do, you know, a video in this. But this is my hot pink little bag, and my little purple, and my blue, and my nude, and my hot pink. And here is a stack of my books. You know, you have to keep the meaning of my story everywhere you go. Even in your closet, you have to have a whole stack so that in case someone wants one, I can go ahead and grab it. Don't pay my change no attention. And a couple of more book bags back there. And yeah, so this is my closet, okay? And it's not the best closet ever. You know, the more wealth that we get, the better this closet will get. It'll have shelves and corners and containers and drawers to open up. And I also have dressers and drawers as well. But this is just the closet section. So you all have seen today my closet, how beautifully color coordinated it is and how it's sectioned. Again, I'm gonna give you the tips just so you be sure to organize your closet in a great, effective way. Number one, you color coordinate your closet. Number two, you season coordinate your closet. So your summers, your winters, your fall, your springs, however you want to do it, you season coordinate. Within each season, you color coordinate. The third tip that I would give you is to hanger coordinate. Now, some people may think that's a little too far. If you're not as extra as me, hey, don't add that tip. But me personally, I like to hanger coordinate, color coordinate, and season coordinate. And those are the three ways that I improve my closet, make it effective for me. Like I told you, if I grab a piece, I put the hanger back in its exact spot. And then when I wash it and it's back ready, or dry clean it or whatever, and it's ready to get back in its closet spot, I know exactly where to go by the section, the color, and the season. So hey, do your closet the same and show me. Send me a video, send me a couple of pics, tell me how great this was. Did it help improve your closet? Do you want more videos like this? Because we were definitely bring them. This is MoreShay with Marshay. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Talk to you guys soon.